Olay. That means hello, right? Olé? No. Hola? Hola, okay. That was a España Cani, and that was a Paso Doble. And if you watch that dance, Dancing with the Stars, oh, lots, huh? I think they do a Paso Doble once in a while. Well, good afternoon and welcome to our annual KCC Concert Band Spring Concert. We're glad you're here. We have a lot of really great music for you today. And we have a nice, some nice contrasting kinds of things for you today. And I'm really looking forward to this a lot. Some great, great music. Our next selection is a very famous and recognizable, the Carnival of Venice. And a lot of folks have played this piece, have soloed with this piece. And we're gonna go right to the top with the piccolo today. Very, very difficult instrument to play, and we have one of the greatest around here, Kathy Crawford, and she's been with, I met Kathy at a band camp, Springfield Junior High School. And I went out to help Strickler? Well, Springfield came in Urbandale Elementary. Holy smokes. Ancient history. At Clear Lake Band Camp. Actually, my first year here, 1975, I got a call and wanted to come out and help some band kids out at the camp, and I said, sure. And here was this little flute player. She was in fifth grade, and she's still with me here playing great flute and piccolo. So, and she's played for our musicals. If you saw our musical in March, Kathy was playing flute and pick in the pit, did a great job. She's been a concert band forever. She did post band forever and teaches at the Music Center and just a great, great person, great player. And it's been great working with her. So we're going to do a little Carnival of Venice.
Thank you. Very, very nice.
Very, very nice. That's a tough instrument to play if you've ever tried to play the piccolo. She does a great job on it. It was wonderful. Our next selection is by Antonín Dvořák, Czech composer. And this is one of our heavier pieces of the day today. Mr. Dvořák was brought to America back in the 1890s. Europeans had kind of a, they were in charge of classical music. We had people over here who wanted America to become part of the classical music scene around the world. So some rich folks in New York decided to pay him 20 times what he was making in Europe to come to America and become familiar with our country a little bit and to write some music. So he wrote a New World Symphony while he was over here, incorporated spirituals into it and all kinds of like American tunes that he put into his New World Symphony. We're going to do the finale, which is the fourth movement of this. This, of course, was originally done for orchestra, and this was arranged for band way back in 1936 by Mr. Eric Lightson. Did a lot of phenomenal arrangements, taking orchestra music and arranging it for concert band. So this is full of a lot of melodies. This challenges everybody in the band. This is a tough piece. We like it. We think you're going to like it too. So sit back and enjoy Dvořák's fourth movement. This is the finale to the New World Symphony.
Thank you.
Holy smokes. Tough piece. Tough piece.
Wow.
Okay, we're going to close the first half with a piece that is a little bit different for us and for you. It's a kind of an emotional piece, and it's called Symphonic Prelude, and it's by Mark Camphouse. And one of the instruments I want you to listen for in this is Drake Olmsted on alto sax. Boy, nice player, nice player. I'm still recovering from the last one, excuse me. But I'm not crying over Drake. But no, Drake's been with us for quite a few years. He works for Kellogg's and just is a nice, nice alto player. Plays with some bands in town and just a great, wonderful guy. You're going to hear some very, very nice playing from him. Mr. Camphouse was looking for some inspiration for a piece, a new piece he was commissioned to write. And he found himself over in Europe. And he went to, and you know, I'm patriotic, okay. We do the Armed Forces salute every year, and I mean at least once a year. And it's important. And Mr. Camphouse, looking for his inspiration, found himself at the cemetery over in Normandy. There's a cemetery there at Colville-sur-Mer. And I think it's been visited by all of our presidents, and there's always ceremonies there. And it's right by the English Channel, and I think it overlooks Omaha Beach. And he found it to be very overwhelming. And a great moving landmark for the American people and for our folks in uniform. And so he used that as his inspiration for this next piece. And he said that the endless rows of white crosses and stars of David were a powerful reminder of the staggeringly high cost of freedom around the world. And we experience that every day now also. As a matter of fact, there are almost 10,000 servicemen who are buried at the cemetery. And the average age is 22. So we're going to play Symphonic Prelude, and it's just gorgeous. And we'll close the first half with this piece. Okay, thank you. We're going to take about a 10 to 12 minute intermission to cool down a little bit and reset for second half. Got a great second half coming up. It's a little bit lighter than the first half, okay? But hey, we're glad you're here. We'll see you in about 10 or 12 minutes. Thank you. Reduced group because of the style of the music. It's very light and kind of elegant and delicate. So I decided to kind of cut down to almost like a wind ensemble type of a setup for our first opening number. Franz von Suppe. Some of you will recognize maybe the Light Cavalry Overture, Poet and Peasant Overture. He wrote a lot of operettas, but they're all kind of like no good and they're gone. But he wrote a lot of really nice overtures. And we're going to play one that's very not often performed, and it's the name of it is Tantalusquillen Overture, and it has 14 letters in it. I think it's Tantalusquillen Overture, and it's kind of like almost in the style of like Offenbach at times, you know, the Parisian kind of a sound, and it's just you'll hear it is very melodic, very light and nice. I also want you, again, now to kind of focus at times on some very, very outstanding clarinet playing by Laura Hurlman. Laura began, let's see, playing for me in post band back in about 1987. And then she kind of stuck through, and she's been one of our just great, great band members. For the musicals, again, she was in the pit for the musicals, a lot of our musicals that we've done. Concert band, she also teaches at the Music Center of South Central Michigan here. And Laura has just been a great supporter of the band and really keeping that clarinet section in line as much as possible. Great gal and a huge, huge Michigan State person. But I've kept her up at the front of the section anyway. we're going to play for you now by Franz von Suppe, Tantalusquillen Overture. Thank you. close with a piece that's it's very light. Joshua, and it's done in a swing style. No dancing in the aisles, please. And one of the reasons I'm closing with this is that it's kind of a jazzy kind of a thing. And next Sunday, the KCC, Kellogg Community College Jazz Band, is having a concert right here at 3 o'clock. Funny, I'm never going to get my yard work done. I'm sorry. But the KCC Jazz Band, right here, we're going to do probably about 12 charts. And I am going to be bringing in some guests to perform with the jazz band. Mr. Terry Lauer, who plays phenomenal piano, is going to come in and play piano for us. Larry Ochiltree, one of my ex-students here at KCC, is going to come in and play drums, along with my regular percussionist. Michael Doyle is going to sit in on tenor. We've got a couple other old geezers playing in the band, along with this wonderful, wonderful oboe player here who plays great electric bass in the jazz band, Jillian Busick. Yeah, she plays great electric bass in the jazz band. So anyway, it's going to be a fun afternoon, 3 o'clock right here, and we're going to do everything. We're doing Latin, we're doing swing, we're doing some funk. All kinds of stuff. It'll be a blast. Okay, so if you're not doing anything, you want to not have to work out in the yard or anything, right here. This is the place to be. Okay, so we're going to close with our swing version of Joshua. Here we go. Thank you for being here. Thank you for all your support. My family, my wife, one of my daughters is here. One of my granddaughters is here. I've been lucky all my life to have support from everybody, family, and everything. I've been very, very lucky. Folks like this back here, I'm telling you, I've been very, very lucky, and I appreciate it. And I love everybody right now. But I love my wife a lot. Anyway, here we go. See, I don't want to stop. This is the last one. Anyway, we'll stop. This is Joshua. Here we go. Thank you.
while the rest of the band is getting out here, I'm just going to just give you a real quick, back in 75, when I got here to KCC, there was no concert band. And I was asked to conduct a group called the American Legion Band. It was a post-54 American Legion in town here, and they had a band that competed in a state contest. So they said, hey, there's this new guy in town, let's see if he'll direct it. I said, sure, I'll direct anything, heck. So I wind up with this really nice group of musicians in town here. And so we go to the state contest up in Lansing, we win the blasted thing. And I remember there was a guy by the name of Byron Autry, who was a huge cornet instructor up at Michigan State at the time. And they came in second, and boy, did I feel good. It was really wonderful. But anyway, so then that kind of became the seed for, because then I came to back to school here and I said, you know what? And I talked to the administration here, and of course, they've been supportive forever with me here. And I said, why don't we try and maybe turn this into a concert band class here, and we can do some kind of enrichment, and some folks can take it for credit and stuff. And that's where we are today. And I actually realized, I think last night I woke up, and I wasn't conducting this time, but I woke up, and I think I realized this is like the 30th anniversary of this group, because it was like 1977 when we started the KCC Concert Band. But actually, yeah. We actually have two members who are with us today, Lynn Juckett, clarinet player, and John Marshall, trumpet player, who are in the original American Legion. Matter of fact, Lynn's dad started the Athens Band Program years and years ago. It was his dad that started that. But anyway, we have two of the original, and there's a couple that are around, but they're playing for money today, who were also in that original band. But they'll be here May 6th for our concert, the gala concert on May 6th to play. But that's kind of a real quick, brief history of how the concert band kind of got started, and we just, it was great, and it's been wonderful. It's been a great, great trip. I'd like to now bring up John Marshall, Mark Adams, Eric Campbell, Steve Schroeder to join conductor Jen Culler, and we're going to do one of the best trumpet trios ever, Bugler's Holiday. Thank you.
Back in March, we celebrated KCC's 50th anniversary with a musical and put together, 37 songs from musicals that were on Broadway back in 1956 and 57. And Gary Kyler and Gerald Blanchard just worked their full heads off. I had a great pitch, so my job was a piece of cake. Dick Day did some great arrangements for the show. And one of the musicals that was involved in that particular period of time was West Side Story. And so we're going to play for you selections from West Side Story by Leonard Bernstein. And the lyrics were done by Sondheim. Stephen Sondheim did the lyrics and Leonard Bernstein did the music. And our medley includes I Feel Pretty, Maria, Something's Coming, Tonight, One Hand, One Heart, Cool, and America. So this is selections from West Side Story.
Thank you. Thank you.
today. But I'm going to see the band again May 6th. Oh, and don't forget Tuesday night rehearsal. We have a concert on May 6th with Mr. Blanchard's vocal department, and I think we'll have about three or four different choirs. Liz Kurnikoski from the English department has some poetry presentations, and it's to celebrate Kellogg Community College's 50th anniversary celebration. And we're going to do three or four tunes and some really nice music, and it'll be a lot of fun. So I'll see these folks again, so I won't get really emotional. But this is our last spring concert, and there's nothing I can say.